So we are live at RGBA today. In the house, Hall of Fame. You know he's nominated for the Hall of Fame this year?
Huh?
Mikey's nominated for the Hall of Fame. Did you know that?
I know that.
Would you vote for him?
Absolutely.
Why?
He's just badass.
How many of Mikey fights have you attended yourself?
I went to...
Wow, I didn't even see that. That's badass.
I went to Easter. I went to Jesse Vargas. I went to... Broner. That was in Brooklyn. That was too far. I went to one more. Oh, the one up in Fresno?
Just three fights? Where have you been the whole career? Like 40 fights, right, Mikey?
Yeah.
Oh, 42 fights.
42
they
fights.
They moved here towards the tail end of their career. So.
No, Mikey... Why you were training?
Yeah, but I started coming around, so, you know,
when Louis came.
Yeah.
You know, your cousin used to live with him.
Yeah.
Where is he?
He's here right now.
Is he coming?
It's Louis.
I don't know.
Hey, who won? Bivol or Better Beard?
I think Better Beard, bro. I think Bivol gave him the best round.
I had Bivol winning.
Every fighter had Bivol winning. Why, Mike?
I thought he boxed very effectively, landed more punches, was more active. Bitterbeef was the aggressor, the one coming forward, but he was not being effective. He landed a couple good shots, but I think Bivol won the majority of the rounds. But, you know.
Was it a robbery?
No, I wouldn't say the robbery. Because, like I said, it was competitive, and I could see how someone might be, you know, in favor of Bitterbeef with his aggression coming forward. And, okay, but I personally think Bivol won. I think he won decision, you know.
99% of people thought Bivol won, but
I thought so.
People said that Bitterbeef would win by knockout, but he didn't look that hot.
No.
He looked fresh in the 12th round. I was very impressed by his conditioning.
For a 39-year-old, I'm very impressed that he doesn't lose a beat. That's
holy.
His conditioning.
Yeah, that impressed me. But I think Bivol gave away those last rounds, bro. Personally. He was just trying to survive.
Can I tell you something? How many rounds do you have to win in boxing to win the fight?
Seven, right?
Good job. Right, Mikey? You just have to win seven. So you don't have to win every round. Yeah. But in this day and age, one just scored it 116, 112.
I don't believe that. That's
really... There was one that had it really close. Who was the one that had it really close?
No, it was a draw. The first guy had a draw. Then 115, 113.
But the 116, 112, whatever it was.
Exaggerated. Hey! Okay, Canelo versus Better Beef. Who wins?
Canelo Bivol?
Canelo Bitterbeef.
Oh, Bitterbeef?
I got Canelo. Bivol says Canelo hits harder.
It's a big difference in weight, though. And Canelo is not one to... I mean, he didn't do very well against Bivol.
But he was injured. I was in camp with him.
I believe it, too. I know.
He's part Alex.
I always said it. I think something was either he was injured or he was sick.
He was injured.
And, you know, he didn't get the best camp or whatever, but I don't know. It's tough. But he doesn't have to fight any of those guys either. He's 168. He stays there. He's good.
Spence and Fondora, who wins?
I thought that's a good fight. See, Fondora with the height. He's on a high right now. He's dangerous. He's tough. Spence, considering, like I said, coming off of over a year layoff and, you know, the loss to Crawford. We'll see how he bounces back from that. But it's a good fight. If Spence is 100%, maybe leaning towards him. But Fondora looked really good. I don't know, man. That's like a 50-50.
So, guys, I'm live over here with four-division world champion Mikey Garcia. He's nominated for the Hall of Fame right now. He's on the list alongside the only other superstar on the list is Manny Pacquiao. There's a lot of stars, but just Mikey and Manny Pacquiao really stand out.
There's like 40 names, bro.
No, they're all big
names.
Very
accomplished fighters.
Who else is a four-division champion?
There's several guys that are very accomplished.
Four divisions is not easy. Yeah, one division is not easy.
They're on the list for a reason.
Okay, do you guys have questions for Mikey? Ask Mikey how or why he became a Pumas fan.
Always Pumas.
What's
number
that?
One. Soccer team.
What city?
Unam. Mexico City.
You like the Pumas? A robber likes America.
A robber don't know shit.
And most people like Chivas.
Yeah, they don't know anything. Pumas, number one. Ever since I was a kid.
Are they popular?
Hell yeah.
Who in this gym likes them?
Nobody. I don't know. They're all American and Chivas fans here.
Why? How come you never fought Loma?
When I was unified, when I was champion at 135, he beat, I think, Crolla right around the same time. And I beat Robert Easter. And he had beaten Linares. Yeah, he beat Linares and Crolla right around that time.
Back to back,
and that's when I beat Robert Easter, and I unified, and he was unified. But never had an opportunity because Top Rank had him fight. I forget who he had him fight. But anyway, he was scheduled to fight. And then that's when I jumped up to fight Spence. But to be honest, if I'm being honest, Top Rank was never going to allow anybody of their fighters to fight.
Especially after you left them.
Yeah. Top Rank doesn't really let anybody fight outside of their, you know.
To their credit, they do a good job. Because look at a guy like Crawford, his 140 run. And Mayweather and De La Hoya,
they know how to do. They know how to do business. They build up the fighter. They fight within the same stable, or they wait till someone moves up in weight class, and then the other fighter moves up and gets that title. And they did that a lot. That's why they had the champions for the WBO title. They had pretty much every weight class in boxing for a while, because they would have them on different weight classes.
Are you with them? So
when one of them moves up from 130, 135, the guy that was at 126 moves up to 130. And the guy that moved up from 135 to 140, you know, he gets the 140-pound title. So then the 135, the 130 moves up to 35, and they do that a lot. And that's perfect. They know how to work the business.
I gotta ask you this: on the live here, a lot of fans say they want you to come back and fight Haney and retire him.
Nah.
Well, how would you do against Haney? Obviously, you have a lot of power. He doesn't have the best chin.
I would have knocked him out.
What round?
I don't know, 7th, 8th round.
Would Bill's trash talk affect you or bother you?
No.
You remember Elio Rojas had a sidekick that was talking a lot of trash? Didn't end well. What do you think of Bivol's wife going crazy after his loss? I'm sure you saw the video. She was celebrating like she fought, like she won.
I only saw the thing on Instagram, so I don't know if there's more to it, or I don't know the story.
She's been posting for a while.
Yeah, I don't know the story. I don't know history.
Is she the biggest hater in boxing
now? I think it's a little petty for someone to go out and do all that publicly, but she has her reasons probably, and whatever. Not my pedo.
Okay. What happened to the Cowboys? Not my pedo. No, they're asking
they didn't
a lot.
Play.
They look okay. They won?
They didn't play.
No, okay. What happened to the Cowboys game? How come they didn't play?
No, I didn't watch it. It was the Lions, right?
They didn't play.
I saw the score. It was like,
oh. They didn't play. they didn't fucking play.
Loma might retire. Yes, I do want to see Loma and Tank. Do you want to see Loma and Tank? They're both champions.
Loma and Tank right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be a good fight. That'd be a good one. Loma looked really good in his last one. When he became champion IBF, he did really good. He showed a lot of the old Loma. Footwork, combinations, you know, he showed a lot of that. I don't know if it might have been like his last, you know, hurrah like that.
He stopped Kambosos.
But he looked really good.
Not easy to go to another country and get the W.
Huh?
Not easy to go all the way to Australia and get the knockout.
Oh.
By the way, Misael is in the house today. Chino! No, breaking news.
He's working out.
He has a rematch. Yeah, not a rematch, but they didn't fight.
Reschedule. Now he's going to have backup now.
Yeah, now he's going to have backup on. You're bringing everybody. I told Chino, he's famous now.
We might end up adding more fights to the card. We might end up having more fights to the card after they get down.
When you were fighting, it was like 60 deep in the locker room. The group pictures?
I never liked all the people coming to my room.
But they all did?
Everybody wanted to be there. And I'm like, go fucking sit down, bro. I'm fucking working. Get your ass up. But everybody wants to be there. Everybody wants to have that experience. Everybody wants to walk out with you. They think it's just like such a cool thing. I don't need you here. I don't need you. You're not going to get in the ring with me. You're not going to help me.
I will say
get your ass in the ring. Let me fucking
10
work.
10 minutes before you walked out, they would announce everybody has to leave.
Tell Robert, hey, make sure you tell the commission.
Yep.
Everybody out.
Yep, and they did
fucking
it.
Do it. And they did. But everybody was waiting on the hallways, staying close by so that we come out.
If they're not in the gym with you every day,
No, but see, it's like, if they don't do that, if they didn't do that, they're not going to have that experience. But shit, I'm fucking working. I don't go fucking tag along at their job, fucking with all my friends tagging along with you while they're fucking working.
Maybe you should do that one. Next time someone talks trash to you, go to their work.
Let me fucking work. Let me fucking get shit done.
Focus.
No, go sit down over there.
Oh, by the way, Julio apologized.
I know.
I didn't know that. What did he say?
I saw that. No, he said he respects, you know, my brother and my dad, myself, and he apologized to Chino for his reaction, but you know, in the moment, and like I said, he's a moment.
But that's how he is. He's very emotional. He's a passionate guy. He's very passionate.
He's kids, you know, his son. So yeah. I get it. So that's what I was never like want to be retaliating with.
No. We're like, it's all sports. It's all. It's all fun. It's all in boxing.
We know how it is. But it's very cool that he did publicly acknowledge. And
by the way, Edgar Berlanga says he knocks out Bitterbaev easy. He said no head movement, no boxing IQ.
He might get those fights and make
hopefully
a lot of money. Good for him if he gets some good fights, good money.
Who wins that one?
Bitterbaev. He knocks him out.
Okay, how big is the rematch of Misael and, not rematch, but reschedule Misael and... It's going to be major news worldwide.
Bigger now. Bigger fight.
Who wins? Omar Chavez or Misael?
Misael. Chino's going to fuck him up. Watch. Chino's going to beat him.
Anything new with Mikey right now? When do you get the results if you're in the Hall of Fame this year or not?
They don't announce that till later. Like December.
Well, I hope you get in. Who December votes for it anyway?
Honestly, I don't know how it
okay
works.
It used to be boxing writers, right?
I heard that. Okay, like I said, and then they changed.
There's no more boxing writers.
The
don't
rules
exist anymore.
They changed the rules.
Yeah.
Because I remember back years ago, it used to be that in order to be eligible, you have to have been retired for
five.
Minimum of 5 years.
Correct.
And now, I mean, I only retired 3 years ago. And